masculinity, McCloud.
I threaten yours?
Your new partner's a woman.
Well, that's what they tell me.
All right, out! Get your hands on the car. Feet spread apart.
You making any progress?
Yes, sir, I'm doing real fine. I stole my first car.
I don't like you. Did you check out? You're walking on eggshells.
Looks like we have an unscheduled passenger. Lose him!
You officers have been chosen for this pilot program because you represent a cross-section. Very wide cross-section of the New York Police Department. Now, the assigning of police women to regular patrol duty in other cities has proven both effective and statistically sound. However, we need your help in selling this concept to the news media and general public. And I'm confident that you will do all you can to make this program a success. Thank you, Sergeant.
The following officers will be assigned to radio cars. Buchanan, Johnson. Murphy, Green. McCloud, Serino. Pagonis,
who are
Kessler.
You?
Sam McCloud.
What are you?
Ramsey and...
Deputy Marshal, Taos, New Mexico.
Sanchez.
This is New York, or did I take the wrong train this morning?
Well, that's a long story, but... Ever since we're going to be closer and pick on dogs for the next 8 hours, I'll give you a chapter and verse.
McCloud, after all the time we spent together, I never thought you'd be fickle.
Well, just following orders, Joe. Besides, Deputy Serino's a lot prettier than you are.
Deputies, but women drivers make me about as nervous as a black widow's husband on his honeymoon.
Let's understand one thing right now, McCloud. As far as you're concerned, the officer at the wheel of this vehicle is neither male nor female, simply your partner.
Well, it could be a mite difficult. No partner I ever had wore the kind of perfume you do.
And as far as my driving skills are concerned, I'll match mine to anybody.
Are we chasing somebody, or are you just testing the siren?
That car ran a red light.
What is this? Trick or treat?
May I see your license, please?
Sure.
Registration?
That's still with the defaulter suite. I just repossessed this car. Triborough Finance Company.
Why don't you write out the ticket while I call in? Now, this is car 1932. Would you check the hot sheet for license number 5F8936? Yeah, we'll wait.
What are you doing? I saw him coming. Look, McCloud. You're my partner, not
what
my
is
protector.
What is it for? He's a move faster. Get in.
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
Didn't that truck hear my siren?
Call 127. Suspect vehicle is not listed as stolen.
Congratulations, McCloud. You just smashed a store window, wrecked a police car, and ruined a perfectly good pair of stockings. We still have 7 hours and 45 minutes to go.
The auto theft industry in New York City has never been as busy or profitable as it is today. Second only to drugs, there's more money being made in auto theft than in any other crime. And that's why I've asked you, ladies and gentlemen of the press, to attend this seminar. Through you, the public must be made aware that auto theft in this city is reaching epidemic proportions. In order to understand better what we're up against, you must first understand how the auto thief works. For example, a stolen car can be fixed up with new vehicle identification numbers and forged registration papers and sold as hot. And they turn up regularly all along the East Coast, as far away as California, even South America. Now, that same car might also be cut up in parts for sale, usually within hours after it's stolen. While the parts that have vehicle identification numbers, such as the chassis, parts of the engine, transmission, are destroyed. Without those numbers, it's impossible to tell whether or not a part has been stolen. Now, most of the men who steal cars are specialists. They're highly skilled at finding just the right car, entering it, and getting it started. With the help of these, a professional can steal a car in less than 2 minutes. If the car has an alarm system, he can bypass it with this. If the car door is locked, he can open it with this, this, or this. And this innocent-looking piece of equipment down here is called a slapper. With it, he can pull the ignition cylinder right out of the dashboard. The well-prepared thief then slips in a standard replacement cylinder, available at about $3.95, and drives off. Virtually impossible to stop a car thief on the street. But what our auto squad does is to make it very tough for whoever is processing the car after the theft. Vulnerable at this point because he must take the car somewhere to change its identification numbers for resale or for cutting it up. He must have a place to work. That means he must be stationary. And that's when he's most likely to meet the auto squad. That concludes this seminar, ladies and gentlemen. Your cooperation will be appreciated. Thank you.
Oh, this'll look great. Just great.
What?
Length of tour, 15 minutes.
That truck came out of nowhere.
30,000 cops in the city, and I gotta draw a cowboy who breaks windows instead of horses. I don't understand.
Chief wants to see you.
You finish this?
No.
Nothing like an honest woman.
Boy, some guys will do anything to get out of a full day's tour.
Joe, I don't want to hear no more about it.
Like the man said, you ain't heard nothing yet.
Man.
Him?
Him.
Why is he out of uniform?
That is his uniform. Marshal McCloud is here to observe our pilot programs when he isn't practicing for the demolition derby.
Truck ran a red light.
Save it for your report, Marshal. I always enjoy a little light reading before I turn in. It's Lieutenant Feldman of the auto squad. He'd like to ask you some questions.
Did you know the car you stopped was stolen?
It wasn't on the hot sheet.
It is now.
Well, the fellow that was driving it had a whole raft full of papers from some finance company telling him to pick it up.
How much did they pay you to wear this outfit?
Enough to go broke on.
Would you like to bet some of it that company doesn't exist?
Well, the way that fella took off like a scalded dog, you probably got a cinch bet.
Did you get a good look at him?
I'd know him in a dark alley blindfolded.
I'll take him.
Sam, are you getting wanderlust again?
How's that?
Well, there are two sure signs that you're itching to get back to Taos. We do a great deal of walking and very little talking. And tonight we have logged 5 miles and 2 grunts.
Well, Chris, tell you the truth, I haven't thought about Taos in a couple of days.
In that case, if I didn't know you better, I'd think there was another woman.
You would? Well, there is.
Well, you certainly know how to let a girl down gently.
She's my partner.
Your new partner is a woman.
Well, that's what they tell me. Of course, it's going to take more than long hair and a short skirt to convince me.
What does she look like?
She's pretty enough in a grim sort of way.
How pretty.
Well, Chris, you don't have to worry about Officer Sereno. Getting close to her is like backing into a cactus. The only thing that we have between us is a policeman's manual. I'm hers from 9 to 6, and after that, I'm yours. Except tonight.
Putting in a little overtime?
With Lieutenant Feldman.
I don't want to know anything about Lieutenant Feldman.
Now, Chris, the only thing that you've got to know about Lieutenant Feldman is that he smokes cigars.
How much time do we have?
Oh, I'd say we had enough.
On the auto squad. Most of it spent like this. Believe me, after a day's work, it's not your feet that hurt.
How long you been on this one?
Almost a year.
Huh?
Only thing I got to show for it is a sore disposition.
That's him.
Richie Garrison.
What about the other one, know him?
Brand new player. Now maybe we just moved up a notch. $95,000 were stolen last year. This year they figure 100,000.
In New York City alone?
Yeah. It's Sometimes they can make more by cutting the car up and selling the parts individually.
The way you're giving him rein, I gotta figure you already know where he's heading.
They've got their favorite drops.
Drops?
Places where they stash a car to see how much heat there is. They never pick one up and take it right inside, wherever inside is. That's why it's so tough to get a make on this outfit. I don't know for sure. If we were dealing with an independent, they'd pick up that car and take it to one of 50 automobile junkyards. Who knows where the car would end up from here? Same as always, wait. I spend 90% of my time on this case waiting for people who never show up.
You want me to grab Garris?
No, we can get him anytime. I want to see who picks up that car and where they take it. It's a magic act. Every time I turn up, they disappear. If I was superstitious, I'd figure I was jinxed and I'd move on to something else, but I'm too stubborn to be superstitious, so I just keep plowing ahead.
There you go.
What time is it?
4:15.
You got a hard day's work creeping up on you.
Yeah, well, I hate to leave you like this.
Oh, in this case, I'm used to being alone.
I'd appreciate it if you'd let me know if anything turns up.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow. Thanks very much for your help and your company.
Big night?
There is a traffic warrant. At its
moments. Let me guess. You watched your girl wash the floors, and then as a special treat, you let her iron some of your shirts.
Well, this may come as a shock to you, but I think women's got a lot more going for them than just that.
But you don't believe they belong in patrol cars.
Well, why don't you ask me that again when we're chasing some fella across a rooftop or looking down the barrel of a .38?
Statistics prove that women are as calm under fire as men.
Well, statistics don't mean too much when the other fellow's using bullets.
Do I threaten your masculinity, McCloud?
No. Do I threaten yours?
Car 127, the 1012, at parking lot, 45th Street and 9th Avenue.
Want the siren, or will it keep you awake?
What time did you leave him?
Around 4.
Kid found him when he opened up at 6.
You were with Lieutenant Fellman last night?
Not long enough, guess. Said he was jinxed.
He was a cop. Cops get shot. Sometimes they die. Obviously, someone was feeling the pressure. Fellman always seemed to be in the way.
Well, maybe that's the problem. Fellas that we're up against can spot a New York cop half a mile away and then get close enough to kill him.
A few hours with Lieutenant Feldman doesn't qualify you for this case.
A man who doesn't look, talk, or act like a cop's got an edge going in.
The auto squad's been trained to handle these things, McCloud.
Well, the auto squad's been knocking on the door for a year now. It's time they had someone on the inside to open it for them.
Well, just suppose, for the sake of argument, I allowed you to pursue this. What would you need?
Well, first of all, I'd like for you to lock up Richie Garris. He's the only one that might recognize me as a police officer.
Anything else?
Well, there could be. I just have to let you know as a go.
Well, satisfy my curiosity on this. How do you intend to make contact when we've only spotted a few of the drivers?
I just have to find some way to get their attention.
What'd you say? Follow that car. That's what I thought you said.
Chief.
Oh, McCloud. Nice of you to check in. You making any progress?
Yes, sir. I'm doing real fine. I stole my first car.
You stole a car?
Well, I found a junkyard over in Brooklyn that'll take all that I can deliver. No questions asked.
McCloud, you cannot go around stealing automobiles. Even for an undercover officer, that is against the law.
Well, Chief, it was already stolen when I came along. Now, I suggest you have a couple of the auto squad boys hot-footed over to that junkyard at 1532 Eastern Parkway and get that car back before they do something to it.
All right. But remember, the people you're dealing with might not see the humor of your stealing cars they've already stolen.
That's what I'm counting on.
on the car. Pete's fresh apart.
Much obliged.
Wants to see you.
Oh, thank God, enough friends.
Then we have to do it the hard way.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I didn't know you were sick.
Send you on a simple errand. You bring back excuses.
He took us by surprise.
You're supposed to take him by... Hello? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. If I get rained on, you better start carrying an umbrella.
All right.
Picked up Richie Garrison. We may have gotten a break.
New York Police Department got a break? Now, don't tell me. Richie Garris offered to turn state's evidence.
Well, no, not that lucky, but he does turn out to be a little more than Richie Garris. His fingerprints made him as Richard Gillard.
Never heard of him.
There's a fugitive warrant for his arrest from the state of Illinois. At least we don't have to worry about him getting turned loose on bail while McCloud's undercover.
Clifford.
I got their attention.
You in trouble?
No trouble yet. No, sir. Leastwise, no more than your average car thief. Now, listen. I want you to check out a fellow by the name of Sandler. Phil Sandler.
Phil Sandler? Who is he?
A fellow who just offered to introduce me to a friend of his. Now, unless I'm wrong, that'd be his boss in this car ring that we're trying to bust up.
Yeah, McCloud, that's good work. I'll send a man over to wire for sound so we can back you up. Now, when does this meeting take place?
It doesn't. I turned him down.
What?
Chief, the way I see it, exposing this gang is like making a move on a beautiful woman. The only way to get to the bottom of things is to make it appear like it's the last thing on my mind.
McCloud.
Well, I have to go now, Chief. I got him on the run, but it's a long way to the corral. I'll call you when I can.
McCloud.
What happened?
Well, the Lone Ranger just rode off into the sunset, or the smog, or wherever you ride off to in Manhattan. However, I think he's getting close.
You don't seem too pleased about it.
Well, we've lost three men who thought they were getting close to this car ring. I don't want to lose another one, even if he is kind of peculiar. Check out Phil Sandler.
Right.
For my kids when they visit.
It's nice.
How's the wife, Roy?
Fine.
And the girlfriend?
Fine, too.
Everybody healthy?
Yeah.
No emotional problems?
No.
And what's your excuse? You assured me if the cop was taken care of, the business would increase.
Yeah, it will. It will.
You're 30 units off this week. There's more heat than ever. And that puts me in an awkward position. I've just recommended you for a promotion.
A promotion?
Out of the circumstances, it's a little premature to discuss.
Mr. Bristol, I won't let you down.
It's not me I'm worried about. Lower the temperature and raise the volume, and then we'll talk about your future.
My friend still wants to see you. Please.
Well, that's all you had to say the first time. Let's go.
Mm-hmm. Why all this fuss over one little old car thief?
You've been hitting my men.
Well, they've been operating in my territory.
In your territory? 42nd to 69th?
My little corner of the world, so to speak.
Oh? Well, it just happens to be my little corner of the world. Get out of town, cowboy.
I'm afraid I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Well, I read in a magazine that New York's the easiest and the best place to steal cars. I just come to make my fortune.
Yeah, I haven't quite figured you out yet.
Open as a barn door in a high wind.
Right now, you're a minor annoyance to me, and I got a lot of bigger things to worry about. I don't want you distracting me.
Well, all I can say is that I guess we're just going to have to learn to live together.
All right. I'm short a driver.
You're offering him a job?
Absorbing the competition.
We don't know anything about him.
We will.
Now, look, this is a big organization, right?
Like General Motors.
Well, I don't cotton too much to big organizations. They can kind of trip you up. But thanks anyway. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You haven't heard Mr. Erickson's last choice.
Cowboy, I'd much prefer to keep things quiet right now, but if that first choice doesn't really appeal to you...
Well, Mr. Erickson, you're a hard man to say no to.
I'm in.
You made contact with the top man?
Well, I wouldn't call him the top man, more like middle management, but it's a start.
Well, don't worry about going too far up the ladder. We don't expect that. Now, just find out what you can about their operation. How they keep from getting spotted, where they're dumping their cars. Any information you get will be an improvement over what we have.
Well, I'll do my best, but the higher I can go, the more I'll be able to help.
McCloud, I'm telling you... No, I'm ordering you. Take it slow and easy. We got a make on Phil Sandler.
And?
He's got an arrest record that goes back to the crib. Medical discharge from the Marines, implicated in two murders. It's all there, no convictions, but enough smoke to spell out one thing. He's a psychotic killer.
Well, I appreciate the information, Chief. I'll try to stay on his good side.
He doesn't have a good side.
Are you telling me to quit?
You want to?
It would seem kind of foolish to go halfway across the desert just to back off at the well.
All right. Stay inside as long as you think it's safe. But the minute that well starts to look the least bit murky, you bail out.
There you go. Oh, there's one more thing, Chief. This better be the last time that I call you.
McCloud, I'm not going to have you out of contact with me even for one day.
Well, then we better find some other way to pass information back and forth. I'm being watched.
By whom?
Phil Sandler.
today?
It's my pleasure. Turn right to second light. I'm just around the corner.
I know. Paid your visit this afternoon.
Well, did you find anything interesting?
The labels in your clothes seem to check out. You don't seem to have anything in your room you're not supposed to.
Well, that's a relief.
Should be. That's why you're still alive.
Careful, but this is ridiculous. I'm just going upstairs to brush my teeth and go to bed.
Lights on in your room.
Well, that's kind of an old country custom. You see, when the sun goes down, we turn the lights on so we don't bump into things.
Yeah. Only it wasn't on when I left. Come on.
Sam! Go!
Who's she?
Friend.
What's he doing here, Sam?
He's visiting.
What's she doing here, Sam?
Well, she's doing the same thing.
Honey, could you hand me my robe, please?
Yeah.
Where'd she come from?
Bronx.
That is not what I mean. That stuff was not here this afternoon.
Man, I'm just dying to meet you. Why don't you come on out and introduce yourself?
I'll be right out, honey.
How long have you known her?
You know, that's another thing that I don't like about organizations. They want to know too much about your personal life.
That's how we stay in business.
How you doing, honey? Hi, I'm Marge Sorrento.
Phil Sandler.
Have you known Sam long?
No, I was just going to ask you that.
You didn't tell him how we met, did you, Sam?
On my own?
Yeah. My car stalled right in the middle of Broadway. Now, can you imagine that? I mean, all those cars honking, cab drivers, and that cop, he didn't even try to get my car started. He just began writing out a ticket. Then Sam came along, and he started that car running just like that. Sam has a wonderful way with automobiles. And that's how we met. That was about a month ago, wasn't it, honey?
Yeah, sounds about like that.
Well, Mr.
Sandler.
Sandler, yeah. Well, we weren't exactly planning on it, but you're perfectly welcome to stay and take potluck.
Oh, well, some other time, perhaps, huh?
Bye.
Bye.
It's going to be a pleasure checking her out.
Know what you mean.
Oh, Sam, I've missed you so much, darling.
Hmm.
Your phone is tapped.
You want some dinner, honey?
Oh, I think we can get her something to eat anytime.
I saw him coming up with you, Sam. It was the only thing I could think of. Because they needed somebody who knew you on sight, and I lost.
Hey, am I glad your car stalled that day?
I've got a lot to tell you.
I'll be right back. What are you doing? Now, wait a minute.
This is the only place that's half safe. I didn't place the bugs.
Okay, McCloud. Just keep your distance.
I don't know if that's going to be very easy. Haven't seen each other in a couple of days. Now, the trucks that they use belong to the same freight company as the rig that ran us off the road. Now, I told you that wasn't my fault.
Nothing's ever your fault, Sam.
Uh-huh.
What else?
Well? Turn the lights out.
Well, the least you could do is offer to sleep on the couch.
I'll flip you for it.
Anything? What? Anything?
Yeah, Phil just left.
What are we listening for?
The rattle of a badge.
Phil thinks he's a cop?
Yeah, well, it doesn't really matter.
What do you mean?
Phil just wants an excuse to kill him.
I don't like you. And I don't trust you. Did you check out? You're walking on eggshells.
395 Second Avenue.
That's you.
395, fare on 63rd between Park and Lex. The fare's name is Blaustein.
You got somebody spotting for you?
That's a Cadillac.
Wearing a green coat. Needs to make a wedding.
I think I could figure that one out myself.
There she is.
That one? Still moving.
Wedding means a special order. They need a green caddy.
Not gonna have much time to listen to the radio.
Just follow instructions.
Erickson, this is Frank. Yeah, well, that's just it. Everything sounds fine. But I got a feeling he and his girlfriend are sharing more than just a bed. Yeah, well, all right, we'll stay with it. Turn that thing up as high as it'll go. I want to hear them blink.
Where you're going, I may lay off a couple of drivers.
Well, like you said, there's always a big turnover. Yeah. Where's this one off to?
South America.
South America?
Yeah.
Boy, I'll bet this baby could make it all the way without getting out of second gear. Yeah, sure do, miss.
You drive one?
3 years ago, practically lived under the hood of one. She always purred just like a contented woman, you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah. Who'd you work for?
Midwest Transport.
Oh, Herman, Sam here's been admiring your rig. Shake hands with Herman Schmidt. He's one of our better drivers.
Hey, there you go. Nice meeting you, Herman. Real pleasure. Seemed like a good old boy.
Beer.
Who are you calling a spade?
Herman Schmidt is in the tombs. Drunk and disorderly, assault and battery.
That ought to keep him occupied for a while.
Now, the trucking company is legitimate.
Legit?
Yeah. Apparently, your friends paint their rigs to match.
And then nobody pays any attention when they see him on the road.
That's right. White's tour company is licensed by the FAA and City Fathers.
Who owns them?
A holding company.
Well, who owns a holding company?
We're still trying to find that information out, Sam.
Well, what about the taxi cab company?
We've narrowed it down to a small fleet of radio cabs.
You shut your mouth off the other day. Let's see if you can back it up. Can you really drive a rig? Or was it just talk?
Oh, I never like to talk without saying something.
Well, Herman got involved in a barroom brawl. And we're short a driver. You like to take a shot at it?
Oh, I don't know. It's,
Afraid you can't handle it, cowboy?
You know, stealing the car and dropping it off real quick, that's one thing. But driving a rig, that's sitting on top 20 years for an awful long time. Seems to me like a man should get paid for the extra risk.
You prove yourself, you'll be taken care of.
Well, you take care of me, and I'll prove myself.
Incredible. The guy is incredible. We don't even know if he can cut it, and he's holding us up for more money.
Don't want to hold you up? Maybe you should wait till Herman gets out of jail.
I didn't say Herman was in jail.
Well, if he ain't, New York City's not like any other town that I was ever in. That's where they threw me the last time I busted up a bar. 6 months, and then when it got out, I had to pay for the damages, $316.17. Never could figure out where they got the 17 cents.
All right. 200 more a week, but you better be worth every penny of it, or we'll take it out of your hide.
Thank you.
Oh, morning, Mr. Bristol.
Hi.
Good trip?
Profitable. We just signed Barry Woodman to front a new line of men's clothes.
Uh-huh.
It's a good way to bury some of our excess profits. How are you doing, Roy?
You tell me.
I'll do better than that. I'll show you. Two units more than you quoted.
Oh, I'll top that this month.
I knew my faith in you wasn't misplaced.
When I make a promise, I like to deliver.
Well, I'm still pushing through that promotion for you, Roy, just as fast as I can.
Thank you, Mr. Bristol. You never told me what it was about.
The entire city. All five boroughs. And Long Island.
Well, I don't know what to say.
That's what I like about you, Roy. You let the figures do the talking for you. You might give some thought to your replacement.
Oh, as a matter of fact, I have a man in mind. Very sharp. New man. Not pushy. You practically have to beg him to take a better job.
You checked him out?
Oh, clean as a Boy Scout's whistle.
He's a cop. I tell you, he's a cop.
He can't be.
He never worked for the Midwest Transport. He never got arrested for busting up a bar or anything else, and half of the out-of-state references he gave us do not exist.
How do you know he's a cop?
What else could he be? Now, I tell you, we have a phony working for us, and you sit there like an old woman waiting for her wash to dry.
I just recommended him for a promotion.
What kind of promotion?
It's nothing important. As a matter of fact, I was thinking of moving you into my spot when I go on up.
When'll that be?
Never. If we don't get rid of our friend.
You're going in the wrong direction. You're gonna make the rest of this trip in the trunk of that car.
Well, that could be a mite cramped.
You'll be too dead to notice.
Just when we were getting to be good friends, you mind telling me why?
You don't check out.
Well, you just now finding that out took you long enough.
Well, better late than never. Okay, cowboy, come on now, move it. Move. Come on. In a couple of hours, you're going to be part of a scrap metal shipment on its way to Japan. Here you are. Open up.
You have any idea why I didn't check out?
Because you're a cop.
Man, I'm glad there ain't many more around like you. You're so stupid, you're blowing a $300,000 deal without even knowing it. If you had the sense of a goose, there might be 10 grand in it for you.
Hey!
I want to see Erickson. I want to see him right now. You are unbelievable. If I'm not telling the truth, there's plenty of time to kill me later. Let's go.
Well, I thought at least you could listen to what he has to say, and if you don't like it, then kill him.
I'm listening.
Car leasing.
You mean you want to lease my stolen cars?
There you go.
Kill him.
Now, wait a minute. Just hold it a second. You're not getting the drift of what I'm saying. I can work your stolen cars through my leasing company. Covers the whole Southwest. Now, I'm moving into California, so I'm even going to need more merchandise.
What's your setup?
One registration from a legit car can be made to spread over a whole lot of hot ones.
And the first time your customer goes in to get his car serviced, the ID numbers don't match.
No. The repairs, the maintenance, everything is done right there on the premise. That's part of the contract.
What happens when the lease is up?
Well, by that time, the cars are so far off the hot sheet, I can sell them through the newspaper.
100 units a week?
Cash on the barrelhead.
Give me a number. 505?
That's the area code, New Mexico.
Get on the other extension.
South Car Leasing.
Mr. Forsythe, please.
May I ask who's calling?
You bet. Sam McGraw.
Yes, sir, Mr. McGraw.
Broadhurst. Well, don't keep the man waiting. Hello, Sam. How's New York?
Oh, it's a little bit chilly. Listen, Harvey, I've got a man here that I want you to give some straight answers to. First of all, what do we gross a year?
About $5 million.
I hate to bring this up on a line where anybody might be listening, but how many units can we cover with one registration?
Well, like you said, Sam, it's an open line.
It may go dead any minute.
10 or 12.
Thank you, Harvey. You just saved my life.
If anybody can answer a phone, even a cop,
say the word and I'll give you a grand tour. You know, I'm kind of proud of my little operation down there.
Somebody will look into it.
Well, can we get started? Do we have to wait till we get down to some serious horse trading?
$3,500 a unit.
Discount for bulk buying, $3,000.
$3,500 firm.
$3,000, I pay my own transportation.
100 drivers?
Nope. One ship. We'll just slip those little babies right up the Gulf.
Oh, that's too big for me to okay. And before I even present it, I'll need $100,000. Advance.
$100,000? $100,000,
Mr. $100,000. And a ship.
And a ship.
This thing is run like a corporation. Right now, I'm dealing with what you might call middle management.
Sam, isn't there any other way?
It would take years to track down all the drops and pickup spots. Now, they gotta have records, books, someplace, and that's what I'm after.
But the higher up you go, the more chance you have of being discovered.
Well, it's kind of like climbing a mountain. If you're worried about falling off, you're not going to reach the top.
Please be careful.
Same goes for you. You know, the higher I get, the closer I get to the top, the more they're going to be looking at me. And my friends. Sure hate to lose a good man like you.
Where are you going?
Try to get some sleep.
I'm not tired.
I'll be back.
When?
When you're off duty.
$100,000.
And a ship.
Department has to scrounge for paper clips. McCloud has suddenly become the Onassis of Brooklyn.
If he doesn't deliver it, they might kill him.
I got $10.
I certainly hope the commissioner's developed a sense of humor in the last few hours.
Chief? You want me to go with you?
No. I can't stand being laughed at in front of my own men.
I've got McCloud wired for sound, so we'll be able to hear everything he says.
Yeah, but how will that thing help us to find him?
Uh-huh. You see, this directional finder will enable us to home in on McCloud's signal, wherever he has to go to reach that top man.
And how long will it remain operative?
4 hours. Continuous transmission. That is, from the moment that I strapped it on him.
Well, for McCloud's sake, I hope he finds that top man before that thing runs out. $100,000.
You know, we checked on that South Car Leasing. You got a right to be proud. It's a beautiful settlement.
Cash and carry. You've seen the money, now I want to see the merchandise. Hold it!
What's the matter?
Well, that drive shaft's hanging so low, couldn't make it down the country road.
Oh, it probably just needs a clamp.
Oh, really? What else does it need?
Well, how should I know?
Well, maybe someone should take a look at what I'm buying. That one's not going anywhere.
What's with him?
Hold it! Hold it!
Listen to those tappets, you hear them? Sounds like a bucket full of marbles in a tin plate. What are we supposed to do? Ask the owners if their cars are worth stealing? From what I've seen, most of them would pay you to take them. Listen to the timing on that. So far off, it isn't even in this century. Look at that. Touch it. It falls off. It's rotten.
Listen, you're getting 100 cars fresh off the street. You notice those tires? Bald as my Uncle Wesley. What do you guys think I am, some country yokel?
Hey, this is beautiful, isn't it? Isn't that nice? Look at that. Maybe I could sell this one to a blind man with no sense of touch.
A little paint will fix that up.
I'm not paying $3,000 a car to put my paint shop on overtime.
You're bound to get a few clunkers.
Now, look, I'm paying for prime. You're trying to slip me a mule with horns.
All right, what do you want to do?
Nothing. Deal's off.
What am I supposed to do with all these cars?
Sell them for scrap.
Hey, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Hold it! Look, get the burr out from under your saddle now. Let's talk
this thing over. We can work something out.
Now, I'm paying $3,000 a unit
for cars that aren't worth $2,000. Now, I'll give you $2,500 a car, and if my repair bill comes to over $200 a unit, you pay the overage. Now, that's my deal.
Well, I can't make a deal like that.
Well, you better find somebody that can.
Look, I'll give you an answer in an hour.
In an hour, that ship's going to be sailing, and I'm going to be on it.
Let me see what I can do.
We're done. Sounds like he's on his way.
That's right. We started changing locations. Moving east to west, the way I make it.
How much longer on those batteries?
Another hour and 15 minutes, give or take.
Give or take one marshal from Taos, New Mexico. Unit standing by, Joe.
Ready to roll.
Now let's go.
We feel this concept will revolutionize the men's fashion industry.
Well, aren't you afraid the men's fashion industry might launch a counter-revolution?
You sound skeptical, Miss Scofield.
Well, I can still remember the last press party of this kind. It was for something called Clarence Jankowski's Drumstick City. It was going to revolutionize the takeout food industry.
If I were as clever as I thought, I wouldn't ask. What happened?
Poor Mr. Jankowski went bankrupt in 6 months and was left holding several tons of turkey legs.
Well, at least he could ease his mistake. I'd hate to dine on a bolt of fabric.
Oh, I'm sure it would be just as tasty as Mr. Jankowski's drumsticks.
Excuse me.
I'll see if I can spring him.
Make it in the Wall Street area about 20 blocks, Chief.
Close the gap.
Sam! Well, look what just blew in off of Mesa.
It sounds like Chris Coughlin.
Is that good?
Enough from a cloud. Let's get there, Joe.
Lonesome Sam, what are you doing here after disappearing for weeks?
Oh, I've been away on business.
Oh, you sound just like Chief.
Well, I'm sorry that if I ran out on you like that, Chris, but it was important. How is Albuquerque?
Albuquerque?
Why don't you introduce us, Sam? I always enjoy meeting your friends.
Especially the ladies.
Oh, I'm sorry. Some other time we got a little business to catch up on.
Sam, this is the first time that I've ever seen you out of the uniform. Have I said something I shouldn't have?
I'll let you know.
I said something I shouldn't have.
Pull out all stops. He's in trouble.
Oh,
those books, they don't have anything. I'll see you later.
Come on, Duncan. Which building?
Dead ahead.
I wish he hadn't said that.
According to this, McCloud is going cross town 140 miles an hour on the diagonal. Haywire.
What does it read?
According to this, McCloud is hovering over East Manhattan.
Oh, no.
What is it?
This is Chief of Detectives Clifford. Put me through to police helicopter dispatch, code 1013, officer in trouble.
Andrews. McCloud, Banks. Edmund.
How should
Arnett.
I address you?
Oh, McCloud Sanchez usually gets my attention. O'Toole. Sam, if you like.
That'll be all.
What's your first name?
My first name's Pat.
Hmm. Oh, excuse me.
Hey there. You're out of uniform.
Thanks to you. Your recommendation got me on the detective squad.
Well, I guess that all those backaches from that spring in the couch were worth it.
At the moment, I'm not too sure.
Hmm?
She's very pretty.
Oh, Miss Banks?
Yeah.
Neither male nor female. Simply my partner.
See that you remember that.
I'll give it my best shot.
Listen, if you're ever thirsty, I have a refrigerator full of beer.
There you go. I'll see you.
Bye, Zee.
Miss Banks, you know, I've got nothing against women deputies. But women drivers make me about as edgy as a black widow's husband on his honeymoon.